Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and welcome to your first look at Li Ming here. I don't even know what this, I didn't even have time for an intro, man. This, golden monkey thing came out here. I don't even know what this is. But yeah, this is your first look at Li Ming. She just came out a moment ago, and I wanted to get a video done as soon as possible. Obviously, this is going to be the bot games, and the reason why, for those of you who are wondering why I'm playing against bots with bots, is due to the fact that basically the queues are incredibly long. That's all I gotta say. Apparently I didn't get the golden monkey. Okay, so I literally didn't even have time to do my little intro, 3 second intro thing, because everything loaded immediately. Anyway, this is your first look at Li Ming, recently just released a moment ago on live, and obviously the queues are really, really long for Li Ming, so that's the reason why I want to make this, sure I get this video out as soon as possible. And yeah, I've never played Li Ming. I just bought her the second that she was out, and yeah, I did watch the abilities overview, but I have not again played her, literally the first time of me being as Li Ming. So very excited that we're going to be getting a new hero, just not even 2 weeks removed from getting Gray Man, the last hero. So going over, oh, apparently we're going up against a Li Ming bot too. This is going to be interesting, because I'm probably going to get shown up by the bot a whole lot. So going over Li Ming really quickly here, her abilities and her trait. Her trait is going to be critical mass. Critical mass will basically reset all cooldowns whenever she gets a takedown. So what a takedown is whenever she gets a kill that she was around for. I don't think that it caught. I don't think she has to participate in it to count as a takedown. But either way, whenever she gets a takedown, it's going to reset all of her abilities, including her heroic abilities, which is very, very, very powerful. Obviously, going over her basic abilities really quickly. Her Q is going to be magic missile. As you do see here, the missiles will fire towards a targeted area, but the trajectory that they travel on are going to be completely different based on where, how far, and how close your cursor was whenever you did the quick cast. Her W is going to be Arcane Orb, which is just a straight skill shot that's going to get more powerful the further it travels. You see right there, wow, so much damage to Kerrigan. By the way, check out the new combat tickers as well. I will be doing a full patch overview later on today. I wanted to make sure that I get the Li Ming video out right now, and of course E is going to be teleport. I think everyone knows what teleport is. You basically just hit E, and it's just going to teleport a short distance. And yes, I know we're already level 3. I haven't looked at the talents yet, but that's because I was talking and I didn't get that stupid golden monkey, whatever that was. So level 1, let's see, astral presence, increased mana regen while low on mana, while below half mana. That's interesting. Power hungry, regen globes give ability power and more mana. Wow, ability power and more mana, interesting indeed. Force armors, magic missiles grant spell block, and then aether walker teleport costs no mana when out of combat. That's also very interesting. I think level 1 here, since I've already missed all the regen globes, I think level 1 will be going for basically just astral presence to give us a little bit of mana regen. Now, of course, as always, whenever I do have a new hero on the channel for New Hero Week, I will always do some builds that I just trying out new builds, man. I don't try to min-max right off the bat. I think it's important that we try to get as many fun builds as possible to show off what a new hero can do. And then at the very end of the week, of course, starting next week, or at the beginning of next week, I'll give you my, quote, final build, which is what I believe is going to be my official final build that I'm going to be playing with said new hero if we do have to go into Hero League, etc., etc. So much damage already, getting a triple kill pretty much here. And you did hear the critical mass going off over and over again, because I was able to get so many takedowns. I could have basically reset all my cooldowns as many times as I wanted right there, at least two. Did we get Malfurion? Yes, indeed. Down he goes again, reset all the cooldowns yet again. So we are doing so much work on Li Ming, and we're just getting started. Yeah, I know we're going up against elite bots, and trust me, I'm going to try to get another game here today, assuming my computer will basically cooperate with me and get another kill on Li Ming bot. We're going to be able to kill Crazy Uncle Chen as well. I can't even stop to look at the talents right now, because we're just killing so many things. Level 4, Charge Blast here. Magic Missile marks the enemies for bonus damage. Arcane Orb pulls enemies. The triumvirate. I never remember how to say that word. Reduce the arcane cooldown at max range. The dominance takedowns restore health, which is also very interesting. So it sounds like she already has a sustainability build that I'm going to be going for. Oh man, I have a feeling I'm going to really like Li Ming. Get another kill. Finally, we are able to get, or we do lose our Punisher, but not before we're able to take down the top 4 here. So level 4, I think I'm just going to be going for Charge Blast. It's going to mark the enemies that I hit with Magic Missile, level 7. Seeker, increased Magic Missile, single target damage. Z's Vengeance, Arcane Orb does more damage from afar. And Calamity Teleport deals damage. let's go for Seeker. It looks like we're trying to a Magic Missile build here. I just started out with. So Seeker will give us an additional 165 damage on a single target. that it hits. Wow, Arcane Orb does so much damage. Going to teleport away short distance here. Trying to back around. So much damage. Look at the mark on the on Kerrigan as well. It's a very, very interesting graphic. Okay, so yeah. So going back to it, this video has been all wonky. It feels weird without me being able to do an intro. I'm going to get away from zerging the elite bots here, because I do want to at least get through all the talent tiers here on Lee Ming, even though it looks like our team is going to be... Well, basically zerging down the enemy team when I try not to game. You know what? I'm trying to show off the new hero. Our elite bots are going in uber tryhard mode right now. But I am very, very excited to do another new hero week here. I know that that we literally just got done doing Greymane. Well, it ended, I guess, technically last week. Given the fact that I had to extend it one day for the final build. But it's very awesome that Blizzard is continuing to uphold their standard of doing a new hero basically every... It's almost every month, I want to say. Although that kind of makes it sound a little bit too concrete. I don't want to mislead anyone out there who may think that I'm trying to speak for Blizzard, but it does seem like they are still sticking with their guns as far as on new hero releases, man. We've gotten a lot of new heroes in the last couple of months, and I'm looking forward to even more. Next Shrine's going to be activating here. And we have a two-level lead up on our enemy team right now. Oh, that was a nice pull, though, by Kerrigan. We are going to be able to take down Sylvanas, and I don't think the enemy team can really go do anything about this. I'm just going to go and start helping out with the skull collection, the body collection, if you want to call them that. And yeah, I know I'm going to look like an idiot for not remembering the pronunciation of that word, but hey, it's okay. It's okay. I've been called worse, I promise you. Teleport over there. Again, you see the critical mass. We get the reset on our cooldowns there. So I was going after Crazy Uncle Chen. Unfortunately, I did not land it with Magic Missile. Aspro, Duncan, Stan, Sergeant Hammer, and Uther, and Sonya all helped me out over here. Nice Haunting Wave. Nice heal, actually, by Utherbot. Man, oh man. We all know how strong Utherbot is, though. I mean, all you have to do is look no further than the game that Jesse Crendoge and I won. And we basically won a 3-5 with bots, and it was great. Oh, critical mass not there in time. So here's a heroic. It's going to be Disintegrate and Wave of Force level. This first time around, just for the first look impressions, I'm going to be going for Disintegrate. Long range channel beam, and again, this has a 20-second cooldown. But keep in mind that if you are able to get a kill there, a takedown, it will reset the cooldown like we did right there. Look how much damage that does. Oh my god. And it goes through everything too, which is hilarious. Oh man, I think we may have found our brand new impact hero. I think she's gonna be the first impact hero that we've seen in a little while now. I mean, because yeah, Lunara wasn't really, I would consider, an impact hero. Greymane kind of was, but man, oh man, neither one of those two felt this like powerful right out of the gate. I guess technically Cho'Gall could be considered an impact hero, but. I don't think too many people are still playing Cho'Gall right now. At least not that I've seen in Hero League anyway. I'm gonna head back down here again. It's not my intention to fly through this build, but to fly through this game here. I want to make sure that everyone gets to see the as many talents as possible. We may not see level 20, but man, oh man, Li Ming doing it up big time. I feel like I haven't even really done anything in this game, and she does so much damage. And again, like I said, I do plan on doing a patch rundown video a little bit later on today, and it will probably be after the Darkest Dungeon video. That video, I delayed that video so I could get this one out because we weren't exactly sure when Li Ming was going to be released. And if you're seeing this, depending on how long YouTube processing takes, you may be seeing this maybe, I guess, an hour or two after she came out, but I promise you, I made sure that I was up as soon as possible to buy Li Ming and then go right into this game here. I knew that queues are going to be really, really bad, and I wanted to get the Li Ming video out. Man, oh man, I'm happy. This is worth waking up early for, and then having to wait around for a little bit for Blizzard to get the servers back online. But actually, the Li Ming release was way quicker than the other releases were. Like Lunara, I remember the Lunara release was heavily delayed. Same goes for Greymane, not as delayed as Lunara, and then Cho'Gall, of course, took forever. So very, very happy about that. Level 13 here. We got Cannoneer abilities empower basic attacks. I don't know why I can't read today. Glass cannons gain ability power but lose max health. Increase your ability power by 15%. Decrease your maximum health by 15%. Illusions creates teleport increases teleport range and damage refreshes cooldown. Interesting. I think I'll be going for glass cannon. Why not, man? Like at this point, At this point, we might as well. So that dropped our HP by 15%. That's going to increase our ability power by 15%, which is hilarious because Li Ming already feels pretty darn powerful, I gotta say. And I haven't even, I mean, I used Disintegrate once. Well, technically a couple times there, but it refreshed the cooldown. Heading back over here just to take care of this this wave up top. You see the mark for death there that the magic missiles did provide here. There's Disintegrate. I'm going to take down one. Take down two. Oh, man. It disintegrates off of cooldown again because I've already gotten a takedown. Look how much damage that is. I don't know if it's because of the simple fact of the new combat scroller or what, but it just seems like it does so much damage really, really quickly. And I'm not making any judgment calls or anything like that. I'm not saying it's OP or anything. I would never do that on a new hero week. I like to give my analysis at the end of the week, let's put it that way. But right now, Li Ming feels really strong, so I'm going to force Malfurion to go into Tranquility there. I haven't even been up to the shrine because I'm trying to keep the bots off of our top fort. There we go. So as everyone knows, I am a huge fan of heroes that have like a sustainability, survivability build. And already from the few talents that I've seen, it looks like that Li Ming does have that. Oh, getting so many kills there. Down goes Kerrigan, down goes Malfurion. Going after Crazy Uncle Chen. Look at that. I can just reset the cooldown. I can just reset the cooldown of Disintegrate over and over again. Oh man, that is hilarious. That is so good. And yeah, I know we're going up against bots, but come on, man. Like, that is pretty awesome, I gotta say. So depending on when this game ends, I may try to get the patch video out before the Darkest Dungeon video comes out, and obviously after this game. So we are going to get another kill there on Li Ming. It's probably not worth it to cancel Disintegrate unless if you're trying to go after multi-kills here. And Sonya is finally going to get taken out by the enemy team here. Just going to go ahead and use Disintegrate. Arcane Punisher just doing so much work here on the enemy team. Nice job with the hammer by Uther. I'm going to back up out of here as soon as we get this keep. There we go, level 16. Whoa, careful there. Careful there, Kerrigan. You're going to get yourself killed. You're going to get yourself Li Minged. Level 16 here. Fireflies, magic missiles, move faster, little cooldown, mirror ball. Magic missiles find two extra missiles. Oh my goodness. Arcane Orb range does 25% more damage and travels 25% further. And the diamond skin teleport grants a shield. That's also very, very interesting. I think that I'd like to... Let's go for mirror ball. That's the one that sounds pretty... oh, God. Oh, that is hilarious. What was the fireflies again? Move faster, lower cooldown. What was the lower cooldown? Drastically increases missile speed, lowers cooldown by 1 second. So that would be a 2 second cooldown for fireflies, and that is amazing. But five magic missiles looks pretty darn cool as well. I can honestly say that out of the new heroes, let's see if I can name all the new heroes that we've had before Li Ming in the last like couple months here. I don't know about chronological order, but I'll try my best. So we had Greymane, Lunara, Cho'Gall, who was before Cho'Gall? Hang on, don't tell me, Lieutenant Morales, I believe. Was it Morales before Cho'Gall? Did it go that far? I think it actually was Morales. I'm probably mistaken on that. But anyway, out of all those heroes that I've just named, all the newer heroes anyway, none of them felt like they made this much of an impact on the field. And that's a good thing. I mean, that's really, really good. That's not, again, it's no slight against the other heroes I mentioned, because obviously Morales is kind of considered top tier right now as far as supports go. Enemy team super duper salty at me right now. Oh, what's happening? What's happening here, the storm? Don't do this. Don't do this. Why am I reconnecting? It's against bots, game. It's against bots. Here's the storm. No. Well, it is, again, this is at the very beginning stages of the release here. I'm just gonna wait. I don't even care, man. I don't even care. Here's the storm. Like I said, the servers just came up. So if the server resets is from Blizzard's side, then that's fine. I'm just gonna wait. I'm just gonna keep on going, man. Hopefully, I didn't die though. I'm gonna be upset if I lost my deathless streak here on the Li Ming first impressions video. But either way, it's no slight towards the heroes that I was talking about. And again, talking about Lieutenant Morales, she was kind of an impact hero. But before her, before Li Ming, and again, I don't really consider Lieutenant Morales to make an impact in the way that I'm talking about, like in the connotations that I'm saying. But the last impact hero that I can truly think of was Kael'thas. And I know that I keep going back to Kael'thas as like my impact hero. Maybe because I'm partial towards Kael'thas as well, but besides Kael'thas, I mean, we had Johanna and we had the Butcher, which again, I don't really consider either one of them to be an impact hero. But what I will say is that from what I've seen so far, Li Ming, she is quite good. And I guess the servers are just going down now. I saw they're apparently rebooting. All right, well, there you go. Oh, thank you, Blizzard. Anyway, I'm going to give this video up right now. I'll do another game later on today, assuming that whenever the servers come back up, and we'll get some more Li Ming action. So, sorry about the abrupt interruption. Obviously, it's out of my control, but I wanted to get this video out just to let you all know that the new patch is out. I'll make a patch video later on today. And yeah, we'll try to get another game with Li Ming, this time going up against real people. We'll wait and find out. So, until next time, so long, everybody!